Dear children, here let us learn about verbs and its usages. Verbs used in different tenses like simple present, simple past and simple future. Let us learn about the simple tense form of verbs. Simple present. We make simple present form of most verbs by adding s or es with the third person singular like he, she, it. For example, bake becomes baked, splash become splashes. If you see in simple present, for all the nouns, either first person singular or second person singular or third person singular, how these verbs used here. You see, I bake a cake, you bake a cake, he bakes a cake. Here, along with the main verb bake, we have added yes. So along with the third person singular, we always use s or es and make the simple present. See, he bakes a cake, she bakes a cake, it bakes a cake, we bake a cake, they bake a cake. The simple present tense is used to express a fact. For example, the sun rises in the east, fish live in water. So it is a fact which cannot be changed. Therefore, wherever we speak about a fact, we use simple present. And we use simple present to refer to an action we repeat regularly as a habit or custom. For example, I get up early every day. Mridula teaches in a school. So these two sentences help us to learn that whatever we do as an habitual action, there we use simple present. And we use simple present to talk about a state or condition. For example, Dad is ill today. Shivkumar and Ramkumar are twins. Here, this speaks about a state or a condition of persons or a thing. So, whenever we use am, is, are, has, and have are also simple present forms when they are the main verbs in a sentence. So these am, are, is are used in simple present along with these nouns. They are I am, we are, he is, she is, it is, and you are, they are. And when we use this have, has in simple present as main verbs, we use have with I have, we have, he, she, it has, you have, and they have. So like this, we form simple present tense using the main verbs that which show about an action, as well as we take these am, is, are as main verbs when they are used as a main verbs in a sentence. Simple past. Simple past refers to an action done in the past. So the simple past is made with regular and irregular verbs. So when a verb becomes a regular verb and it takes a form in the past tense having D or ED at the end of it. For example, bake is a verb in present time and baked is a past time verb having ED at the end. Splash is a present time verb and splashed is a past tense verb. Here we could see along with the verb splash ed at the end. So it is a regular verb. Whereas irregular verbs do not form the past tense and they do not have d or ed at the end. For example, you see eat becomes ate, break becomes broke, and lie become lay. So in simple past, when we use irregular verbs, we totally change the spellings and the sound of the verbs used. Now we could see the use of simple past. The simple past tense is used to talk about an action that happened in the past. For example, India won its independence in 1947. So now we are in the year 2020, but we got our nation's independence in 1947. Therefore, it occurred in 1947, not in 2020. So anything that takes place in the past becomes a simple past tense. And they chopped the fruits quickly. Any action done in the past, it can be just before 5 minutes, just before 10 minutes, or 1 hour, 2 hours, a week, a month, like that. But any action done in past becomes a simple past. And we also use this simple past to describe an action that was completed in the past. For example, Amuda and her family lived in America for 11 years. Fiona broke the antique vase yesterday. So these actions occurred in the past, and whenever we use any action done in the past, we arrive at simple past tense. And we use simple past tense to describe a habit in the past. For example, we went cycling every morning a few years ago. That means we are not doing it in the present, but the action was done in the past. So it was a habit in the past, and here we use simple past to describe it. Dad cycled to school every morning. So here, the dad used to bring the child to school by cycle every morning in the past, not in the present. Now we will learn about the simple future. We make the simple future form of most verbs by adding shall or will as helping verbs before them. For example, we can use I shall work, or you shall go, or he will come. So in these sentences, shall, will, it becomes a helping verb. You see, I shall bake, we shall bake, he shall bake, I'm sorry, he will bake, she will bake, it will bake, they will bake. So here in simple future, we always use shall, will, can, may. All these helping verbs in order to make a simple future tense. We use simple future to describe about something that will happen at a later time after the present moment, that always will take place in future. For example, they will finish building the house in 6 months. It means they are not going to complete the construction by today, rather they may take time, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, and even 6 months, or it could go ahead also. We shall complete the work maybe today evening, tomorrow morning, or day after tomorrow, or next week, or next month, but we are not sure of the time, but we shall complete. Therefore, whatever the action done in future, it refers to simple future. So in simple present, we make simple present tense by adding S or ES with the third person singular nouns like he, she, it. And when we make past tense, we change the verb by using regular and irregular verbs. In the regular verbs, we add D or ED with the main verb. In irregular verb, that ED or D will not come after any verb, rather the total spelling as well as the pronunciation itself may change. And in simple future, we use shall, will, can, may, might, like these helping verbs to make simple future. So dear children, it is a simple lesson and very basic for our language learning. Therefore, keenly listen to this lesson and prepare yourself for the examinations. Thank you.